What will the first spacecraft we send to Alpha Centauri look like? In 2018, the Parker Space Probe came so close to the Sun that it accelerated and reached a speed of 430,000 miles per hour, or 700,000 kilometers per hour. If we had a human-crewed spacecraft that could go at this speed, we could cover the distance between the Earth and the Moon in just over 30 minutes. But despite such impressive speed, it would take that spacecraft more than 6,000 years to cover the distance between Earth and Alpha Centauri, the closest star to our solar system. You heard that right, 6,000 years. That's a long time, right? But what if we could invent a spacecraft that could go much faster than the Parker probe? Is the human race capable of developing a spaceship that can go at a fraction of the speed of light with modern technology? The answer is yes. Do you want to know how? Stay with us to find out. Alpha Centauri is the closest star to our solar system. Despite this, the distances in the universe are so tremendous and space so immense that although Alpha Centauri is only 4.5 light years away, with the fastest spacecraft we currently have, it would take thousands of years to reach the star. But even if we managed to create a spacecraft like the Parker probe that could travel a little faster, perhaps at 621,371 miles per hour or 1 million kilometers per hour, that still would be enough to reach Alpha Centauri in a reasonable amount of time. Another problem we found is that the fastest ships we've created so far aren't designed to carry humans, as they're uncrewed spacecraft. Manned and unmanned spacecraft. Size and weight are the main differences between a manned and an uncrewed spacecraft. Unmanned spacecraft are usually smaller than manned ones. For example, the Voyager spacecraft averaged 12 feet or 3.7 meters in diameter and weighed approximately 1,590 pounds or 722 kilograms. In contrast, the Apollo 11 spacecraft was composed of three parts: the command module, which housed the astronauts, the service module, which contained life support and propulsion systems, and the lunar module, which included both the descent and ascent modules for the moon landing. The total weight of the three modules was approximately 72,928.9 pounds, 33,080 kilograms, and together they had a diameter of approximately 50.7 feet or 15 meters. This is much more than the weight and diameter of the Voyager probes. So to get to Alpha Centauri, should we use a large, heavy, human-crewed spacecraft like the Apollo or a light, small, unmanned one like the Voyager? Human-crewed spacecraft are significantly larger than uncrewed spacecraft due to several technical and safety factors that must be considered to ensure the life and well-being of the astronauts on board. While unmanned probes such as the Voyager 1 and 2 or the Parker probe are designed exclusively for scientific data collection, human-crewed spacecraft such as Apollo and Crew Dragon must meet much more complex requirements related to habitability, protection from space hazards, and life support systems. One of the main factors contributing to the larger size of human-crewed spacecraft is the need to create a safe and functional environment for astronauts. This includes providing living space, life support systems, oxygen, water, food, and protection mechanisms against space radiation. For example, the Crew Dragon spacecraft, designed to transport astronauts to the International Space Station, the ISS, have advanced systems to maintain a breathable atmosphere, control temperature, and provide basic supplies for the crew during missions of several days or weeks. On the other hand, unmanned probes do not require such systems, as they are designed to operate in the extreme conditions of space without human intervention. Another critical factor is the need for exhaust and return systems. In manned missions, it is essential to have mechanisms that allow for astronauts' safe return to Earth. The Apollo spacecraft, for example, was equipped with a command module that returned to Earth's atmosphere with astronauts on board after completing the mission. In addition, the Crew Dragon is designed with emergency escape systems in case of failure during launch. These systems, together with heat shields for re-entry into the atmosphere, considerably increase the size and complexity of human-crewed spacecraft. On the other hand, although technologically advanced, probes such as the Voyager or the Parker probe are more compact and lighter. They are designed for long-term exploration missions, but they are unmanned and do not need life support systems or re-entry mechanisms. For example, the Parker probe, designed to study the Sun, is much smaller than human-crewed spacecrafts and can withstand extreme temperatures without bulky structures. Speed is the most important thing to go to other stars. It is clear that if we want to go to Alpha Centauri, we will have to go very fast. But how fast? Considering that Alpha Centauri is approximately 4 light-years away, a ship traveling at the speed of light would take 4 years to reach it. However, since modern science makes this impossible, we could settle for reaching a fraction of the speed of light. 10% would be enough. 10% of the speed of light is 30,000 kilometers per second. At that speed, we would reach Alpha Centauri in 40 years. What type of spacecraft could reach such a speed? Manned or unmanned? Unmanned spacecraft can reach significantly higher speeds than manned spacecraft due to several technical and design factors, including the type of propulsion used, mission objectives, and how they use gravitational assist. Unmanned spacecraft can be optimized for high-speed, long-distance missions without ensuring the safety and comfort of a human crew, while manned missions require limitations on acceleration and exposure to extreme forces. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Types of propulsion. Using Voyager 1 and 2 spacecraft and the Parker probe as a reference, they use chemical propulsion in their early stages but rely heavily on gravitational assist to reach their high speeds. The Parker probe, for example, is designed to study the Sun up close and uses gravity-assisted maneuvers to increase its speed to more than 700,000 kilometers per hour, making it the fastest object ever built by humans. In contrast, the Apollo and Crew Dragon spacecraft use chemical propulsion systems, mainly liquid fuel, which have limitations on how fast they can reach due to the need to protect the astronauts on board. Gravitational assist is a technique that uses a planet or moon's gravitational field to change the spacecraft's speed and direction. This occurs when a spacecraft passes close to a celestial object and uses its gravity to accelerate, similar to a cosmic slingshot. This maneuver allows the spacecraft to increase without expending additional fuel, which is crucial for probes traveling interplanetary distances. Uncrewed spacecraft, such as Voyager, took advantage of the gravitational assist of several planets. For example, Voyager 2 used the gravity of Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune to increase its speed and follow its course toward the solar system's edge. This strategy is critical for probes that need to travel long distances with efficient fuel use. The Parker probe also performs multiple gravitational assist maneuvers, using Venus to approach the Sun on each orbit, increasing its speed each time. In contrast, human-crewed spacecraft such as the Apollo and Crew Dragon are designed to travel within the Earth-Moon system or to the International Space Station, the ISS. On these missions, the speed is carefully controlled to avoid subjecting astronauts to extreme G-forces, which could harm their health. Apollo used limited gravitational assist maneuvers to correct its trajectory towards the Moon, but not to increase speed significantly. Likewise, Crew Dragons perform precise maneuvers to approach the ISS, but their maximum speed is much lower than unmanned probes. The weight of a spacecraft is a crucial factor that directly influences the speed it can reach. Uncrewed spacecraft, such as the Voyager and Parker probes, are much lighter than human-crewed spacecrafts, such as Apollo and Crew Dragon, allowing them to use the energy their propulsion systems generate better. According to Newton's second law, force equals mass times acceleration, if a ship is lighter, the same amount of propulsion force will generate more significant acceleration. This means that a lighter ship can accelerate faster than a heavier one for the same amount of fuel and energy. Weight also influences the amount of fuel needed to move at high speeds. The greater the mass, the more fuel is needed to reach a certain speed, increasing the amount of additional mass, the fuel itself, the ship must carry. This results in a cycle where the additional fuel increases the overall weight, which requires even more fuel to achieve the same speed. Smaller spacecraft, such as unmanned spacecraft, can reach higher speeds since they do not require as much fuel to accelerate and acquire higher speeds. Manned ships, on the other hand, are larger and heavier, so they require more fuel and still can't reach the speeds of unmanned ships. So if we want to send a spacecraft to Alpha Centauri, it will definitely have to be an unmanned spacecraft, that is, a space exploration probe like the Voyager or Parker probes. But how could we make an uncrewed spacecraft reach an immense speed in a short time and reach Alpha Centauri in a reasonable time? The best method so far? Today we have three main methods for powering spacecraft. 1. Chemical fuel propulsion. 2. Electric propulsion with ions and plasma. 3. Gravitational assistance. Of these three, gravity assist gives us the greatest thrust since it does not need fuel and takes advantage of the planet's gravitational force. The problem is that it only works if planets or celestial bodies are in the way. As far as we know, once a spacecraft leaves the solar system, it will encounter absolutely nothing until it reaches its destination. That is, gravitational assist cannot be used once we leave the solar system, so it does not seem to be a method that will help us reach Alpha Centauri quickly. In turn, chemical fuel propulsion is good for shorter trips, but not for prolonged trips in the interstellar vacuum, while electric propulsion is similar. The only three methods to propel spacecraft are not helpful for interstellar travel, so necessarily we have to analyze two possible propulsion alternatives that can be created with modern technology. The first is to use nuclear pulse propulsion. Pulse nuclear propulsion is a system that uses controlled bursts of nuclear energy to propel a spacecraft. Unlike chemical or electric propulsion, this method relies on the detonation of small nuclear bombs behind the ship. Each explosion generates a shockwave that pushes a skid plate attached to the ship, providing continuous acceleration. This technology was studied in the Orion project in the 1960s, but was never implemented due to concerns about using nuclear explosions in space. However, if we were to apply pulse nuclear propulsion to an unmanned spacecraft, such as the Voyager probe, we could reach speeds far more significant than those achieved with current technologies. This system is estimated to accelerate a spacecraft to 10% of the speed of light, approximately 30,000 kilometers per second. At this speed, an interstellar mission could reach the nearest star, Alpha Centauri, in about 40 years. A radical improvement. And 40 years is much better than 6,000 years, right? Although nuclear pulse propulsion has never been proven, the technology to make it a reality exists, and the only thing that prevents us from testing it is the treaties on the non-proliferation of nuclear weapons, NPT, signed by several countries which do not allow the use of nuclear bombs, not even for scientific purposes such as this. The second is propulsion with solar sails and high-powered lasers. Solar sail and laser propulsion are advanced concepts that use the pressure of light radiation to propel a spacecraft. The system is based on deploying an extraordinarily light and reflective sail, pushed by photons, particles of light, emitted by an external source, such as the sun or powerful lasers from Earth. Although the initial thrust is low, acceleration builds up over time, allowing a ship to reach extremely high speeds without fuel. Breakthrough Starshot mission is an example of how this technology could be applied to send tiny probes toward Alpha Centauri. In this project, a series of lasers on Earth would be aimed at the solar sail of a small spacecraft, providing the necessary momentum for the spacecraft to accelerate little by little each year, until after a couple of years it reaches 10% of the speed of light, approximately 30,000 kilometers per second, with which it could reach Alpha Centauri in 40 years. Although this technology has not been proven, as with nuclear pulse propulsion, the technology to create it exists. The main obstacle to this method of propulsion is lasers. It is estimated that the lasers to power a spacecraft the size of the Voyager probes would have to be huge. It would involve a multi-kilometer staged array of beam steerable lasers with a combined and coherent power output of up to 100 gigawatts. Although it is not impossible, it will be tough to build, and the first advances in this method will take several decades to see. As we have seen, human-crewed spacecraft are too heavy for interstellar travel, so the first spacecraft to visit Alpha Centauri will be unmanned. In addition, the only three methods of space propulsion currently available do not work for interstellar travel, so we will have to wait for a new method to be developed that allows us to propel a small spacecraft in the interstellar vacuum. The two most promising methods are pulse nuclear propulsion and solar sails powered by powerful lasers. Both have pros and cons, but whichever one is used for the first interstellar trip, what is certain is that the spacecraft that will be sent will be tiny, perhaps a microsatellite the size of a soda can or even smaller. The smaller the spacecraft we send, the faster it can acquire speed and reach Alpha Centauri faster. Now we want to hear your opinion. Tell us, which of these two technologies will first become a reality? Pulse nuclear propulsion or solar sails powered by powerful lasers? Let us know what you think in the comments.